Hey, it's Clay, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol HMPQ. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 30-minute in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks here representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one represents 30 minutes. While this here may look like several days worth of time, it's actually just today's price action broken down into 30-minute time slices. I like you this time frame. I think it does a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price, and then makes mapping out levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. I've been doing this analysis on a very routine basis, so that's where these green and red line annotations are coming from. And after today's price movement, want to get some things updated here. First off, and I think I talked about this on Friday, but I can't remember. But from a presentation standpoint, so me as the presenter, this is a very tricky chart to talk about because there's a lot of perspective that goes into it. What do I mean by that? Well, if you're a day trader and you bought right there, or maybe you bought right there, and you wanted to sell within 25 minutes after buying, then yeah, for you, the chart's looking pretty bad. Now, if you care about the big picture of things, then yeah, I get it. There's been a big pullback. But from the big picture, the price does still have an opportunity to build a higher base, and as long as you have higher bases being built over a longer period of time, that's how those long-term uptrends are constructed. I'm going to be talking about things from the big picture perspective. So if I sound crazy calling something bullish, my guess would be you just had a different outlook and strategy going into the trade. And really the easiest way to illustrate this revolves around this green line that I've talked about in past videos right here at 0.0248. And then as I, you know, that's been the level of support that I've talked about. And not to pat myself on the back, but that definitely the pat charts on the back. You can see that today. That's essentially right where the price hovered around all day. A couple of times didn't quite hit it. Other times got slightly below it. But point being, the main area of congestion was at 0.0248, that green line there. And that's so important because let's just say the price continues to just do what it's been doing. So it flirts around this area some more, and then starts to work its way back upwards. What would you have in this situation? Again, emphasis on the word big picture. Well, from the big picture perspective, you'd have a set of lows right there. You'd have the previous set of lows down here before the breakout. If you picture these as overall big picture stair steps, then you have stair steps still progressing in the upwards direction. And that's the name of the game. That's what a truly strong move is going to do over time. It's going to make progress forward. And in this situation, I'm defining and quantifying that phrase, make progress, as 0.0248. So yeah, I 110% realize that if you're a day trader and you bought up there, you couldn't care less about these levels down there. But that's where I try to kind of qualify and disclose and offer up a warning that I would be talking about things from a big picture perspective. So yeah, the price has pulled back, but pullbacks are part of the game. As nice as it would be for a stock to be able to go up and up and up every single day, that's just not the reality of the matter. The reality of the matter is pullbacks need to happen, and as long as they're healthy pullbacks and go through healthy consolidations, then overall trends, you know, that's how they are, you know, built in the upwards direction. And so far, so good. I would still consider this a healthy consolidation because not only is the price maintaining this green line, it's still up above the purple line right there, the 50 period simple moving average, and that's what you want to see. So the week is young, still 4 days left. Let's see how this continues to unfold. One of the biggest questions I get is, hey, Clay, how do you find the stocks that you trade? So what I've done is put together a free resource guide where I talk about the tools that I use to locate stocks that I find interesting and think may have potential. So if that sounds like something that could add value to you as a trader, then click on the image that is up on the screen right now, and I will email you the guide. The guide itself is very short and to the point, and best part, it's completely free. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions.